Bonjour.
Spaniard.
Shalom. Shalom. Terry's Jewish, by the way.
Here we go. How did you know? Did you ever get it?
Terry, are you still mad at me?
No, I was never mad at you, actually.
I said some nasty things on Facebook.
Oh, I didn't know that.
No, you did. You deleted me.
I did?
Yes.
Oh, no. Seriously?
So, I saw Great White at the PVA, Pomona Valley Auditorium.
I remember that.
When Shot in the Dark came out.
Yeah.
It was one of the greatest rock shows.
We played with Motorhead there once, too. But I remember that because I knew the guys that had the PA company, Bruce and Irv. They had, it was called Mammoth Sound. And we actually filmed that show with an 8mm camera that's still around somewhere.
It was an epic show because outside of seeing Michael Schenker, I've never seen people so in love with what was happening. The PVA, like only people in the 80s and 90s would understand what that place was.
It was electric, yeah.
You guys did Shot in the Dark, and the audience actually like went on the stage. They invaded the stage. Do you remember that?
Yeah, it was a crazy night. And it's a funny show because I looked like the first man on the sun or something. I was jumping around like a crazy man.
I mean, people really got on the stage, and you were like, you guys were incredible.
The fans were really hardcore. They followed us from the very beginning, and, you know, that was the start of everything.
For those people that didn't see a show at the PVA, what was that like for you? I mean,
well, at that time, it was like the biggest thing in the world for us, you know? I mean, it was coming out of the clubs, playing slightly bigger venues, and having the fans come down, so it was exciting.
So, back then, what level were you at when you Shot in the Dark, PVA, not the hugest venue in the world, but still a big deal, and the audience, I've never seen that kind of love for the audience, except for Michael Schenker, Country Club,
right, right.
80s. I've never seen the audience do that before, and you allowed that to happen.
I think we kind of proved ourselves locally, but on a global stage, we hadn't yet. So, you know, we were excited about that, but we knew that we had to come with a record that was going to get national attention, and we were able to do that with Once Bitten and Rock Me and all that. So that was another kind of a couple notches, another plateau, you know. We can always get better, that's what I always say.